of this year. So give glory to the Lord. Woo. Yeah, so over to you, Baba. Baba dipersilakan untuk bertugas. Dipersilakan.
Mari kita berdoa lagi bagi kita. Saya mengajak kita semua untuk bangkit berdiri.
All together, Lord.
Amen. Baba, on video, please.
Thank you.
mengenal Tuhan. Mari sebelum kita mendengarkan firman Tuhan, mari kita angkat tangan. Kita persembahkan.
Thank you.
Terima kasih, jemaah yang dipersilakan duduk.
Hello, Mom.
Thank you, Baba. Now we go for Holy Communion.
Did you want me to give it or?
Yes, Pastor Daniel, please. Thank you.
Yeah. So Heavenly Father, we just come together here, Lord. We just I'm just going to read here from John chapter six, starting at verse 48. This is where Jesus had come back to Capernaum after and was talking to his disciples. And he said, I am the bread of life. Your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, and man may eat thereof and not die. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eats of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. That's his own word, Jesus' own words. Then the Jews thereof strove among themselves, saying, how can this be? How can this man give his flesh to eat? Then Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, except you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you shall have no life in you. Whosoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eats my flesh and drinks my blood dwells in me and I in him. As the living Father has sent me to live by the Father, so he that eats me, even shall he live by me. This is that bread which came down from heaven. Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead, but he that eats of this bread shall live forever. So, Lord, we just thank you for what you've done, Lord. And I'm going to read here from 1 Corinthians chapter 11. This is where Paul is speaking to the church in Corinth, in Corinthian church. They said, I received with the Lord that which he also delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night which was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it, said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. So, Lord, we thank you for your broken body, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, that you went to the cross for us, Lord, and suffered, Lord, and died, Lord, because by your body we are healed, Lord. And it says in Isaiah chapter 53, he was despised, rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we had, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we smitten him. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for iniquities, the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. So, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for your broken body, Lord, that you are the bread of life. And we thank you, Jesus, that you died on the cross, Lord, you shed your body for us, Lord, and for the healing, Lord. And we just pray for so much healing, Lord, this nation and all of the nations, Southeast Asia and Canada, North America, Africa, all the continents of the world, Lord. We need mighty healing, Lord. And you are the one that can heal people and set them free. So we thank you, Jesus. Let's partake of the bread of life, Jesus.
Okay, Baba. Sudah? Okay, sekarang ambil roti, okay? Yeah. Oh, they are still distributing the bread and the water, the end, Baba.
Yeah, I'll give you time.
Yes, okay. Okay, ambil roti, Baba. Makan. You're still distributing it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bapak sudah? Sekarang angkat cup, minum. Kalau sudah siap. Oke, sama-sama ambil. Dalam nama Yesus.
Yeah, so after the same matter, this is what Paul said after the same matter. He took the cup, and when he had supped, he said, this cup is a new testament in my blood. This do ye often to drink it, in remembrance of me. Paul concludes, for often eat this bread and drink this cup, you show the Lord's death until he comes. So we take the bread. So thank you, Lord, for your shed blood, Lord, for the propitiation of our sins, Lord. We shed your blood, Lord. You are the bread of life, Lord, in your blood. We thank you for it. We take this bread, this blood now, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Daniel.
God bless. Okay.
God bless you. Okay. So sekarang kita akan mendengar firman Tuhan. Terima kasih untuk semua yang sudah bertugas dan pujian dan penyembahan. Sekarang kita persilakan Pastor Edward to preach, ya, yeah, untuk menyampaikan apa yang daripada Tuhan from his heart, ya. Yeah. Over to you, Pastor Edward, untuk menyampaikan apa yang Tuhan sudah letakkan dalam hati kamu, dalam hati Pastor, untuk disampaikan kepada semua pada hari ini. So let us welcome Pastor Edward from Spring of Life Church Tambunan, Sabah.
Now we got two worship team today. Tuhan, terima kasih pagi ini. Kau sungguh baik, sangat baik. Tuhan, kami berdoa dalam nama Yesus. Saat ini kami mendengar benar firman-Mu. Pakai hamba-Mu untuk menjadi sesuatu yang berlaku. Nanti kau menyatakan isi hati. Terima kasih Tuhan kerana hormat dan kemuliaan kami kembali. Hanya di dalam nama Yesus kami mengucap syukur dan berdoa. Amin. Amin.
Pastor Edward, boleh kasih kuat lagi ke orang punya mic? Ya sudah. Can you all hear from Pastor Edward? Pastor Edward, boleh kuatkan sedikit audio karena tidak dengar. Ada apakah di sana audio apa tuh speaker? Pastor Edward. I call Pastor Nico. I will call.
Rosta,
you see? Sikmat lagi. Boleh?
Yes.
Okay, this on for you. Hurry up.
Shalom. Good morning.
Morning.
I'm very thankful for Pastor Rostia, because he gave me opportunity to preach a gospel today. So thank you very much for this opportunity. Thank you for Pastor Charlie, Pastor Marco, Pastor Papa David. Thank you very much to give opportunity to preach a gospel today. Today I want to share with you about third Pentecost. For introduction, without Jesus, we are nothing. We are nothing without Jesus. So God chose us as a servant of God and used us to be a channel of blessing of this world. So many population in this country, so many population of in this street in Malaysia. So why God chose us? Because God wants to use our life to be a channel of blessing of this world and to be ambassador of this world. God can choose someone, can call someone, can change someone, can build a character someone to be a channel of blessing of many nations and countries. God take the time to build your character, your thinking, your soul, and spirit. And God wants to use our life to be a servant of God, to be changed this world. Before God wants to use, God wants to destroy our personal ambition, motivation, and perception about this world. God want to kill and destroy our enemies in our life. No, our enemies is our flesh. So now we go to the Word of God in Acts of chapter 2, verse 1. I think I already sent the note to your handphone via WhatsApp. Pastor Rosia, receive it? Okay, we continue.
Okay, I'm here.
Chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And they appeared unto the cloven tongues like as of fire, and it set up upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with the other tongue. And the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling at Jerusalem, Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Now, when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and were compounded, because that every man heard them speaking in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all these which speak in Galileans? And how here we every man in our own tongue, wherein we were born. Parthians and Medes and Elamites and dwell in Mesopotamia and in Judea and Cappadocia, in Pontus and Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, in Egypt and in the part of Libya about Cyrene and center of Rome, Jews and Presbyterians, Cretans and Arabians. We do hear them speak in our tongue the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed and were in doubt, saying one to another, what's mean this? First Pentecost, all the disciples all together in upper room, and Holy Spirit come. They are all filled by the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak in other tongues. God, the Holy Spirit changed the disciple at the time. Change in spirit, change motivate, change their mindset. All things in life of disciple at the time, changing by the power of Holy Spirit. That is the of Pentecost, first Pentecost.
Pastor Edward, can I just interrupt a bit? Can you also do it for the Bahasa?
A book of Acts, chapter 15, verse 16. After this, I will return and will build again the tabernacle of David, which is fallen down. And I will build again in ruin thereof, and I will seek it out. Joel chapter 2, verse 28 to 30. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your son and your daughter shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young man shall see vision. And also over the servant and over the handmaid in those days will I pour out my spirit, and I will show wonder in the heaven and in the earth, blood and fire and billow of smoke. First Pentecost. Second Pentecost. Pentecost is in Azusa Street. God chose Pastor William Seymour, African American, to be a messenger at the time. And Pastor William Seymour prophesied that 100 years after empowering in Azusa Street, God wants to empower again Holy Spirit and make restoration and transformation Christianity in this world. 2021, time for empowering the power of God to this world. 2021, time for God to empowering the power of God in Malaysia. 2021, time for empowering the power of God to Asia. Are you ready for that? To receive the Holy Spirit, receive the empowering of the Holy Spirit in our life and make the changes in our life. Brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we hear of First Pentecost and Second Pentecost. Second Pentecost is the messenger is William Seymour. Now, Third Pentecost. Before, what happened before the Pentecost? First, God want to shake the world. God want to shake politician. God was shaking economy. God want to shake Christianity. God want to shake all of in this world. All things in this world shaking by God. COVID-19 shaking the world. But I think God have a planning of what happened in COVID-19. When the COVID-19 come, so all the world shocked and shaking by God, by COVID-19. Economy shaking, all things shaking. So all things is broken when God want to shake. Brothers and sisters, when all things is broken, God can fix when all things is broken. Now the time God want to fix all things with the power of God. In our life, we feel God want to shape our life. What happened before third Pentecost? We received the power. Holy Spirit, when he come in our life, Holy Spirit make a restoration, transformation in our life. And we are to be a new creation in God. We are different. We are not same with the world. We are different when we have the power of God, when we have anointing from God, when we do the ministry, we are successful. God choose the ordinary people to do ministry. With the power of God, ordinary people can do the extraordinary in ministry. Sign and wonder with them. God fulfills the power of Holy Spirit and special anointing for the church now. Brother and sister, when the Holy Spirit come, when the Pentecost come, third Pentecost come, make the, all the people in this world beg or repent to the Lord. Hallelujah. It is time for third Pentecost. That means God wants to empower his Holy Spirit to the church, to the servant of God, because we must continue and to finishing the greatest commission from God. Before Jesus come for second time, we must be prepared. We must be finishing the great commission of God. So are you ready? Are you want to take a part of this? Amen?
Yes.
Now, we are entering the new season. New season is a third Pentecost when the Holy Spirit comes and we start to change our life, change our brain, change our worship, change everything in our life. We are not same like a people like this world, but when the Spirit comes, the Holy Spirit can change our life. God can give the vision. God can give the anointing for us to do the ministry in this world. We enter into a new season. Revival starts from inside, goes to outside. Revival starts when we pray, fasting, crying, and worship the Lord. When the second Pentecost, the wave of revival from west to east. But in third Pentecost, when the Pentecost, the revival is not from the east. That means the wave of revival of this world start from the east to the west. Hello, from east, I am from east. So I am ready to bring the fire of revival to the west. And I want to be, I give my life, I surrender to Lord, I give my life, I said, God, use my life to be a channel of blessing of you, bring the fire of revival around in Malaysia, around in Asia, and around the world. Are you ready for empowering of the Holy Spirit? Okay, now we take the time to pray. We pray that God empowering power of Holy Spirit to dark Asia and use the dark Asia, all the seven o'clock in dark Asia, using by God to starting and bring a fire of revival. Amen. Let's we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship Lord before we pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Holy Lord, You holy Lord,
What is the
Tuhan, terima kasih hari ini kesempatan yang diberikan Tuhan untuk kami mempromosikan kebenaran firman Tuhan. Meskipun permintaan kami agak sederhana Tuhan, tapi Roh Kudus akan memberi cerahan pengertian lebih leluasa dalam hati kami, dalam roh kami, sehingga kami Tuhan, Engkau gerakan bergerak kepada arus Pentekosta ketiga, di mana kami sedang masuk kepada era baru, atmosfera baru, di mana kami mulai berdoa di gerakan untuk bergerak dalam revival yang besar yang Tuhan akan rencanakan di tempat kami dan di dunia saat ini. Terima kasih Tuhan, kami pemula revival. Kami pemula revival. Pakai kami semua Tuhan untuk berdoa untuk revival. Dan Tuhan, Engkau pelengkapi kami dengan urapan, dengan kuasa daripada yang Maha Tinggi. Terima kasih Tuhan, puji nama-Mu. Di dalam nama Yesus, kami mengucap syukur dan berdoa sama mengatakan, Amin.
Thank you, Pastor Edward. God bless you.
Thank you.
Okay, amen. That is Pastor Nico. Edward,
why don't we on our mics and sing together?
Okay, let us worship together. Okay, we'll pray.
Lord God, Holy, let's on our mic.
each one of us. Thank you, Father, for giving us your Holy Spirit. Father, to fill us with your Holy Spirit. Yes. 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 Yes.
Yes.
I believe that you will use this law. Revival. Hallelujah. Many secrets that still reveal it to us, your children, Father, and you teach us how to obey it, Lord. Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor Edward. Terima kasih, Pastor Edward, dan juga atas firman Tuhan yang begitu luar biasa. Terima kasih. Thank you so much for Pastor Nico. Pastor Nico is Pastor Edward eldest son. He also a pastor. So thank God. I'm so glad to see him there.
Okay, good.
Yeah, and I'm so glad to see you all. So I believe that truly this is the time our God, the Holy Spirit, our Abba Father, is going to raise us up. Because there are so many happens in our life that we never think. Ada banyak perkara dalam hidup kita yang kita tidak pernah pikir kenapa kita harus melaluinya. Kenapa harus ada COVID? Kenapa harus ada kesakitan dan sebagainya? Why I suffered? Why I experienced so many negative things and suffered for sickness and so on. But God is faithful. Tuhan kita yang setia. So we have testimonial time this morning, today. So I will give it to you this time, Elder Moses and Elder Anna, for your testimony. Elder Anna dan juga Brother Moses, baru-baru ini mereka dua-dua ini dan keluarga mereka kena COVID dan keadaan mereka sangat agak kurang baik, terutamanya Elder atau penatua Moses. Tetapi kita terus berdoa di dalam kita punya persekutuan doa segala bangsa dan juga di dalam Drive Asia. Dan Tuhan telah bekerja dengan luar biasa dan mereka ada di sini bersama dengan kita. Mari kita beri kemuliaan dulu kepada Tuhan. Give glory to the Lord for that. God is so wonderful. So over to you, Elder Anna and Elder Moses.
Yeah, I want to thank God. God is good all the time.
Amen. All the time. God is good.
I say my Vivo first, we get positive in COVID, then the KKM say want to take us to the hospital, the near our place one, Jawi. Then I say no, because I say I want to admit to the private, and then they say you make sure you got place for you. So we call a few island and that Adventist, they send no place, no bed. So we have no choice. We have to go to Pantai. And then both of us is the first patient in Pantai COVID.
Wow.
How to do, what to do to us. The doctor just leave us at the room 1 week and then never come, just at the door and then come and see us. How are you? Are you okay? If you fever, you call the nurse will come and check. And then we stand at the door then the nurse just check our fever. So we are the first, what they call it, the case is number one actually. Then we stay for 1 week, I become number two, he become number three. The category become number three. Then they do nothing. And then my son also in KL, admit to Pantai, KL. And then as he discharged that day, he asked somebody to drive him back and then he go and meet the doctor. He say, why you do nothing to my parent? Now they become very worse. My father, my mother is still okay. Then he said, we have no experience. Then my son said, you call the Pantai KL, the KL Pantai and ask. They give me medicine. They every day take my blood test. You didn't do nothing. How can? They never take our blood test. After they take the blood test of my husband, become category 3. Wow. Then he got heart attack. He got blood pressure, diabetic. It's quite serious. Ayo. We really pray. I pray. And then my mind doubt. Then the God say, be still and know that I am God. So every day I put the hymn, be still and know that I am God. And I sing. When I feel lonely, feel dark, I sing. I want to thank God that you all pray for us. And then we also pray. Then God heal him. He don't need to go to the ICU. The oxygen dropped until 91, 92. Then the nurse say, tak boleh, tak boleh, macam tu tak boleh. Saya mau panggil doktor. I say, why tak boleh? Is that serious? Oxygen drop means no good. She told me. Then I continue to pray and ask. I ask Charlie to ask your prayer and I text you all, ask your prayer. Really, God heal us. Really, I know it's God heal whole my whole family. I thank God, really thank God. God is so good to me. And then I got the second testimony. Last 3 days, my niece called me that say, auntie, my brother fainted again. Last time he had fainted and operated the brain, no? And then coma for nearly 2 weeks. Then now he say, my brother fainted again at home. Now I want to send to Pantai because they are next. The opposite is their house, Pantai. So I call my sister. Then my sister say, what should we do? I say, we pray. No ICU, no operation. He will wake up. He will wake up now at home. Then I say, his name is Lam Kok Ming. I said, in the name of Jesus, Lam Kok Ming, you wake up yourself. You alert yourself. Jesus told me to tell you this. I just at my room, I shout and pray. I kneel down and shout and pray. Then the ambulance reached the house. Then my other nephew also reached. Then my nephew called. When the nurse called him, he wake up himself. He already wake up. He now he can walk. He's staying at the fourth floor. He walk down with the nurse and then go to the hospital. Praise God. God really answered my prayer. It's very true. Whenever I pray, always answer. Really true, many times already. Many times God answered my prayer. I really thank God. I give God all the glory. I praise God. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Thank God.
Wow, what a wonderful testimony. Praise the Lord. All glory to Jesus. Yeah, so maybe I can translate a bit in Bahasa.
Yes, do.
Okay. Terima kasih Elder Anna dan Elder Moses. Tadi kita sudah mendengar kesaksian bagaimana Tuhan itu begitu baik kepada Elder Moses dan juga Sister Anna dan juga keluarga mereka. Sebenarnya mereka ramai yang kena COVID, termasuk anak dia juga. Tetapi yang paling teruk adalah Elder Moses. Dan ada beberapa waktu di dalam grup WhatsApp segala bangsa, selalu, dan waktu kami berdoa di dalam persekutuan doa segala bangsa juga kami selalu menangis. Kami benar-benar menangis waktu kami berdoa untuk Sister Anna dan keluarga Elder Moses. Kami berdoa karena merasakan ikatan kekeluargaan yang begitu hebat di dalam hidup kami sebagai anak Tuhan. Dan kami percaya bahwa tiada yang mustahil bagi Tuhan. Dan setiap kali saya juga berdoa untuk mereka, saya juga menangis karena saya tahu Tuhan sangat baik. Ya, dan itulah yang terbaik. Dan kita tadi dengar Sister Anna bilang mereka berada di hospital sudah 1 minggu, tetapi tidak ada rawatan yang dijalankan dan keadaan Elder Moses suaminya semakin menurun sebab dia ada masalah darah, dia ada masalah ini kencing manis dan juga jantung, dia punya oksigen juga, tekanan oksigen juga menurun. Dan kalau sudah kurang sebenarnya dari 95 dan 91, 92% itu sebenarnya bukan baik. Saya pernah melalui ICU, jadi saya tahu tentang ini. Dan ini tidak baik dan mereka tidak dapat buat apa-apa. Tetapi kemudiannya anak sesayana yang kita doakan di dalam bersama-sama di dalam pelayanan Dab dan juga di dalam persekutuan doa segala bangsa, kemudiannya dia dikeluarkan dan kemudian menghubungi ya hospital pantai di mana dia sudah dirawat di sana. Kemudian mereka buat ujian dan ternyata keadaan Elder Moses itu atau penatua Moses itu semakin teruk. Tapi kita terus berdoa dan kita mendengar bagaimana Sister Anna dan Elder Moses juga mereka, iman mereka semakin teguh di dalam Tuhan. Mereka semakin berteriak kepada Tuhan dan percaya akan kebaikan Tuhan. Dan akhirnya selepas almost 2 weeks, right?
Yeah, 2 weeks.
Yeah, 2 minggu kemudiannya Sister Anna bilang, percaya kepada Tuhan dan dia berteriak kepada Tuhan. Tidak ada pembedahan, tidak ada masuk hospital. Ya, dan ambulans sudah dipanggil untuk mengambil dia dari rumah karena hospital pantai itu cuma dekat saja dari rumah abang dia itu. So, dia berdoa dan berteriak kepada Tuhan. Dan kemudian dia dihubungi, dia sudah sadar. Dia katakan waktu itu dia berdoa, dia panggil nama ini, Lim Kok Winko itu sudah sadar, bangun, sadar. Nah, begitu, dia perkatakan kehidupan dengan iman ke atas brother ini, brother Lim. Karena saya percaya semua ini karena kebaikan Tuhan. Di dalam grup kita, di dalam doa, segala persekutuan doa segala bangsa ini, bagi kamu yang sudah bersama dengan kami, sudah melihat bagaimana banyak kerjaan Tuhan bersama-sama, apabila Tuhan mulakan satu kumpulan yang kecil, kemudian ia membesar menjadi satu persekutuan yang erat, atau Holy Communion yang tadi kita sudah ambil bersama itu, Holy Communion, Communion itu maksudnya kita melakukan kebiasaan yang sama, bersama-sama dalam satu tubuh Kristus yang menyatukan kita. Dan oleh bilur-bilur Yesus kita sembuh. Saya percaya melalui apa yang Tuhan sudah letakkan dalam hidup kita bersama-sama di dalam pelayanan, when we are together and in unity and all nations prayer and dove in Asia, we believe that we are going to see more things of God happen in our lives. And we are the vessels of God. Kita adalah rumah Tuhan. Kita adalah rumah Tuhan. Kita adalah satu tubuh yang telah Tuhan pakai to reach out for the lost souls, to help the lost souls, and to bring out the gospel all over the earth. Jadi kita bukan kebetulan ada di sini. It's not a coincidence that we are here, but we are the ambassador of God. Kita adalah wakil duta Tuhan Yesus sendiri di bumi ini selama kita masih hidup. So puji Tuhan, praise the Lord for all the great testimony. We have a lot of testimony here and we're gonna to pray today. Kita sudah melihat begitu banyak kesaksian di sini, bagaimana kesembuhan daripada stroke, daripada banyak penyakit yang lain, termasuk COVID, lumpuh dan sebagainya, bahkan yang buta, dan juga dilepaskan daripada cengkraman iblis, pemulihan keluarga dan sebagainya. Dan itu adalah whatever happened around us, whatever we are seeing happen in our midst, that is all from God. And God can use that to bring his glory into this world. So we are going to pray for our dear brother Tony Lim. He got prostate cancer. So I would like us... kita ada
not cancer. Problem. Sorry, Rostia. It's not cancer. It's just a problem. It's not cancer.
I'm sorry about that.
Tony, don't mind. Can you turn on your camera so that problem. We can pray for you, Tony?
Is it?
It's not cancer. Yeah. Tony, don't mind. Turn on your camera so that Pastor Rostia can pray for you. I don't know whether you can hear us.
Need to pray.
Namai, proceed. Go ahead.
Okay. Let us. Mari kita letakkan angkat tangan kita. Let us stretch out our hand to our dear brother Tony Lim.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day that you have made for us, Lord, and we want to rejoice in you. Father, Lord, we want to thank you, Lord, because you have made us see so many good things in our life, Lord, and we want to thank you, Lord, for preserving us from evil, for preserving us from many things that we can't face alone. But we want to thank you, Lord, because you are a faithful God. Thank you, Father, Lord, because you are faithful and you are always faithful. Thank you, Father, Lord Jesus, because through this small group, Father, Lord, and you bring us together now, and we began to grow in a big group and become international group, Lord. And we want to thank you, Lord, because this is your heart for your children, so that all nations shall be saved and shall know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Thank you, Father, Lord Jesus, for the assurance that we have in you as our Lord and Savior. Father, Lord, at this very moment today, we would like to uphold our dear brother Tony Lim, Lord Jesus, especially concerning his health, prostate problem, Lord. We didn't know what is happening inside, Lord, but we know one thing, Lord, that you can fix things in the name of Jesus. So, Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we speak life and light be upon our dear brother Tony Lim prostate right now. In the name of Jesus, we command you to be healed, to be made whole in the name of Jesus, and to become normal again and function normal in the name of Jesus. You are healthy to function as Jesus has created you to be in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray every clothing, every toxic inside the stomach, Father Lord, the small stomach, the big stomach, Lord Jesus, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus, be cleansed by the blood of Jesus. Every food has been consumed or drinks that is not holy, be removed from that body in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, we pray for God intervention, for God intervention even right now in the name of Jesus, and we believe the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus, from top of the head to the sole of the feet, feel him right now and bring healing. Thank you, Father. We give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Papa David, can you please pray for Ibu Nomi, Bapa Majun wife? She's been hospitalized because of the diabetes problem. So she's been hospitalized, and the leg swollen, become black. So kita berdoa untuk Ibu Nomi, istri kepada Bapa Majun, supaya kakinya yang bengkak dan menjadi hitam karena diabetes itu sembuh dalam nama Yesus. So kita minta Papa David untuk lead us in prayer. Papa, unmute please. Unmute, can't hear you.
You want me to pray for Papa Majun?
Wife. His wife. Nomi.
Nomi, okay.
Yeah. Diabetes, yeah, you hear that, right?
So yeah. Let us stretch our hand.
Mari kita angkat tangan kita ke Tuhan.
Stretch our hand in faith.
Kita angkat tangan kita dengan iman untuk kesembuhan Ibu Nomi.
Wherever we are.
Dimanapun kita berada.
Wherever we are together, even in this international group.
Dimanapun kita berada di dalam grup ini.
You know, Lord Jesus, you are with us.
Kami tahu Bapak Tuhan Yesus Kristus, Engkau ada bersama kami.
Yes, we can feel Jesus in this place.
Kami dapat merasakan Yesus ada di sini, di dalam ruangan ini.
You know of his presence even now.
Kami tahu akan kehadiran-Mu Tuhan, hadirat-Mu bahkan saat ini.
Yes, your presence is good enough for us, Jesus.
Dan hadirat-Mu Tuhan sudah cukup bagi kami, ya Tuhan Yesus.
Yes, Lord Jesus, you are the Lord that healeth.
Engkau adalah Tuhan yang menyembuhkan.
You are the healer.
Engkau adalah penyembuh. Hallelujah.
You are the one that gives the power of healing.
Engkaulah satu-satu, engkaulah yang memberikan kuasa kesembuhan.
You are Jehovah Rapha, Jesus.
Engkau adalah Tuhan yang memberikan, Yesus.
And therefore we know that you are here today.
Dan kami tahu engkau ada di sini pada hari ini.
You are in the hospital room.
Engkau berada di hospital.
You are now, even now, Naomi knows of your presence there.
Dan saat ini ya Tuhan, Ibu Naomi tahu akan kehadiran-Mu ya Bapa.
Jesus, we see your hand touching her.
Dan melihat tangan-Mu menjamah Ibu Naomi saat ini.
Your hand touching her legs.
Dan engkau menjamah kakinya saat ini.
Your hand touching, stroking her hair even right now in the hospital room.
Dan engkau sendiri ya Tuhan, dengan tangan-Mu engkau menjamah dia saat ini di hospital sekarang ini.
We know that the liver begins to function again.
Kami percaya Bapa di surga bahwa kaki itu akan berfungsi lagi.
You have changed that liver to become new again.
Dan kami percaya Tuhan bahwa hatinya juga Tuhan, kakinya Bapa di surga akan diberikan yang baru.
So that all those cells that helps to prevent the sugar from destroying the body is restored.
Dan kami percaya Bapa di surga bahwa gula yang berlebihan di dalam tubuhnya akan dihancurkan di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus supaya hatinya dapat berfungsi semula ke seluruh tubuhnya Tuhan.
Naomi can see the leg now becomes normal again.
Bapa, kami percaya bahwa Naomi akan melihat sekali lagi bahwa kakinya akan berfungsi lagi.
The foot that is so swollen and black has returned to normal shape and normal color.
Dan kakinya yang bengkak juga akan kembali normal sekali lagi dan berfungsi.
Because the hand of healing has touched her even right now.
Kami percaya roh kesembuhan sudah menjamah Ibu Naomi bahkan saat ini.
So Lord Jesus, we take your name today.
Dan Bapa di surga, kami bersyukur kepada namamu pada hari ini.
We come as a body of Christ even today.
Dan Tuhan, kami datang sebagai satu tubuh dalam Kristus hari ini.
And we proclaim and declare restoration for Naomi.
Dan kami siarkan kesembuhan dan pemulihan kepada Ibu Naomi saat ini.
That she will now jump with joy of healing and happiness. Thank you, Lord.
Dan dia bersorak-sorai atas kesembuhan dan kata sukacita kesembuhan yang dialami saat ini.
Terima kasih. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your promise that you never leave us nor forsake us.
Terima kasih atas janjimu bahwa engkau tidak akan pernah meninggalkan kami atau membiarkan kami.
Thank you, Abba Father, for looking down on us, and that is you saw Naomi as your own, as your favorite child.
Terima kasih Bapa di surga, karena Engkau memandang kami dari surga ya Tuhan dan melihat Naomi sebagai anak kesayangan-Mu ya Bapa.
Thank you for releasing this miracle in the name of Jesus.
Terima kasih Tuhan karena melepaskan mujizat ini di dalam nama Yesus.
We come in complete agreement as a body of Christ.
Ya, kami datang di dalam satu persetujuan bersama sebagai tubuh Kristus.
We come in common union in the name of Jesus Christ.
Ya, dan kami datang di dalam kebiasaan kami yang bersama di dalam nama Yesus Kristus.
Because we believe in Jesus.
Dan kami percaya di dalam nama Yesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Terima kasih Tuhan.
Hallelujah.
Aku juga akan berdoa buat Henry. Henry actually last week has been asking. I mean, he's been coughing for 1 month. So the doctors, you know, he's under treatment now for the lungs infection. So let us pray for Henry. Masih di sini kah? Yeah, his line I think not really good, but we'll pray him then. And pray for me too. Yeah, pray me pray for me too. And then, but before that, I want to say something about Jackie. We all been praying for Jacqueline Curley. So what happened is a few days ago, she texted and tell me that the husband finally confessed everything that he has done to Jackie back in Canada and even to the boys, how it has affected their life. And he repent and he apologized to his family. And the whole family now reconcile and they are so happy. So Jackie asked me to tell you all that he want to thank God for that and thank you all for all the prayers. Yeah, God is wonderful. Dia dapat memulihkan keluarga yang sudah berantakan, keluarga yang hampir musnah oleh pekerjaan iblis. Tapi kita terus berdoa dan berdoa. Kita ada sesi khas buat Jacqueline dua minggu yang lalu, dan akhirnya suaminya sendiri datang kepada dia minta maaf dan mereka dipulihkan. Jadi puji Tuhan. Itulah yang Tuhan mau terjadi dalam hidup kita. That is what God wants to be in our life. To see how God work and then God bring reconciliations because he is God of love. So that is so wonderful. So hallelujah. I'm so thankful for that. Sangat bersyukur kepada Tuhan. Yeah. So, and Sister Anna, can you please pray for Henry?
For Henry? Yes.
Yeah, Henry, for the lungs, restoration and complete healing.
Okay. Yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, we lay up to you, our brother Henry, right now, Father. Father, as he's having cough for a month, oh Lord, and the lung infection, Lord, I pray that, Father, Lord, whatever virus, whatever that caused him to have this cough, I pray and bind in the name of Jesus. I pray for complete healing. I pray that the lung will be functioned perfectly according to your mighty will, Lord. Yes, Lord, he will be healed in the name of Jesus, O Lord. Amen. Amen. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Healing will be upon him. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, you can heal me and my husband Moses. You can heal my nephew. God willing, also, yes, Lord, I believe and I trust and I know you can also heal our brother Henry right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Yes. You are the healing God. Amen. I give you all the glory. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. Are you still there? Sister Janet, can you please pray for Thanksgiving to Jacqueline? Thanksgiving and ask God for continued protection to this family of Jacqueline Kelly. Yeah.
Wow, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. You're such a good, good Father. We thank you, Lord, that you hear our prayers, God. And you answered so quickly, Lord God. We thank you, Jesus, for the spirit of repentance, Lord God, that came to that family, God. We pray for a spirit of reconciliation to come, Lord God, to restore, God, that which was broken, God. You came to give life and life abundantly. And we thank you for that, Lord. And I thank you to continue to add life more abundantly to that family, Lord God. I thank you for the wisdom and the counsel of the Lord for them, Lord God, to know how to proceed, to go further, Lord God. Lord, to draw closer to you as a family, Lord God, to give their hearts to the Lord and begin to walk with you, Lord God, step by step, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. You are such a good, good Father, Lord God. And we just thank you for household salvation, God, and healing and deliverance. And everything else we need, all the provision, because there's nothing that's too hard for you, Lord. Lord, we just thank you, Jesus, that you're just going to continue to protect them from not only this virus, God, but from all the demonic activity, Jesus, that you are the most high, God. And we honor you, Lord God, for what you're doing amongst them, Lord God, and what you're about to do, Lord God. Would you praise God?
Yeah. Ask for special prayer. Saya mau supaya kita berdoa bersama-sama untuk keluarga Ariel. Mereka sedang berada di Beaufort. Untuk semua yang Baba dan for all of us, I would like to ask for special prayer for Ariel's family, for their two of their brothers in Philippines, they positive COVID-19, and also for protection, and also for and for them here in Sabah, for Ariel's, Pastor Ariel's family. So can you please pray for that, Pastor Mel?
Okay, let's pray. Father, we thank you for the wonderful testimonies that we've heard. Indeed, you are able to heal yesterday, today, forever. Jesus, you are the same. So right now, we stretch forth our faith, we exercise our faith, and we declare healing, perfect soundness for both our the two brothers that are in the Philippines, and for Pastor Ariel and his family that are presently in Sabah. We pray, Lord, for the lungs to function normally, for the air sacs to open, excess fluid, every infection to go, for the air to flow through unhindered, for breathing to normalize. Holy Spirit, breathe through this family. And we pray, Lord, that they will recover. If they're convalescing right now in wherever they are, Lord, we also believe that you're able to walk into that room and to touch them. So touch them right now, Lord. And we pray for those who've not been infected to be protected. We apply the blood to cover this family. And we thank you for healing them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. So is there any urgent prayer? Ada permintaan doa lagi? Sebelum itu, thank you Sister Ariani karena menyertai kita hari ini. Thank you Brother Tony Lim, and all of you. Welcome Pastor Takur, Sister Kim, and also Pastor Tongham. I saw you there. Yeah, welcome. So glad to see you all. So is there any urgent request? Ada permintaan doa lagi? Berdoa untuk memberkati Israel, and then we will be,
you know. Pray for our sister Rosha. Rosha, I got lungs problem. Pastor Tako, can you do that? She forgot about herself.
Okay. Father God, we come before you, Lord. Coming to Sister Rostia and our challenges, Lord, we heard about this. But you already know, and you are, Lord, you care and you love her and protect her, Father. We pray all the complex and things that we don't know, but that you are above everything. You can heal her, you can touch her, you can, Lord, touch the lungs and all the things that are unbalanced, that the things need to be balanced physically. Lord, we pray that you will touch and heal her, and Lord Jesus, you make it Lord work and function in proper way, whatever the challenges physical she has, Lord, and whether she is under medication and what the doctor says, whatever. Lord, the treatment is going on, whatever it is, but you are, Lord, above everything, and you can heal her and touch her. Father, we ask your grace, your mercy, your work in her life, in her lungs, and all other things that are complex in her bodies, that whatever is impurity or whatever is going wrong, whatever is in her body as a pain and problem and things, but you have the solution. You do the solution. We trust you. We ask you and ask your Holy Spirit to touch and strengthen her. Give her a lot of the peace. Give her a lot of all the things that she needs, and help her. Father, we ask your grace and mercy in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Let me say something today.
Thanks.
I'm so happy. We are so happy to see families. Normally, we have prayer meeting, we don't see the families, but this Sunday service, we see families.
Yes.
We see Tako's family, we see Tongam. Tongam? Tongam family, Tako's family, we see all the families here. Okay, I'm so glad. So next day we have people. We please bring your families. The Baba families. Max is there. Max, hi, Max.
Hi.
Max is there. Max is behind Rochelle. So yeah. We welcome. I think it's wonderful to see so many families here. Okay. Yes. I think we're all very blessed. All right, back to you, Rochelle.
Okay, thank you, Pastor Charlie. Thank you for mentioning my name. Yeah, I really appreciate that. Actually, Henry is one of my people here. One of, in fact, they are helping me a lot in clothing ministry. Actually, Henry adalah seorang daripada dan istrinya membantu di dalam pelayanan kita punya, apa tuh? Pelayanan pakaian ya di Sabah dan dia juga sebenarnya tiba-tiba sakit dan kita berdoa untuk dia dan kita ada banyak pelayanan bersama dan banyak jiwa-jiwa yang terima Yesus biarpun di tempat kita jual baju. Tadi saya percaya ini adalah actually I can tell it it's an attack. Ada satu serangan secara spiritual atau secara rohani. Tetapi kita percaya kita anak Tuhan, we will never stop serving the Lord because He is with us. Amen. Yeah, the more we facing a problem or we facing an attack, the more we pursue God. Semakin kita banyak menerima tantangan, cabaran, serangan, ya terus maju dan buktikan, hey, who are you? I come in the name of Jesus. Siapakah engkau yang mau melawan aku? Kau salah orang lah. Saya anak Tuhan Yesus. Yeah, but then I decided also to lose weight and to look after my health better. Please pray for us for that, me and my husband. I think my husband losing 5 to 7 kg of weight. Yeah, and I'm trying my best also to lose weight at least 10 kg. I can do that. Orang kan suki nonton ya, because saya terlalu berat. Macam Pastor Charlie, dia pandai diet itu yang sehat. Tanya dia apa rahasia. Ya, ya, okay. So, this is our family, and I thank God for all of you. And yes, I'm so grateful. Saya sangat bersuka cita karena melihat kamu dan sebagaimana Pastor Charlie cakap tadi, saya melihat begitu banyak keluarga. Dan sebenarnya ini yang sangat penting Tuhan mau. Itu sebab ada satu lagu. Satu hal yang kupinta lebih dari, ya, lebih baik satu hari di pelataranmu daripada 1000 hari di tempat lain. Aku memujimu, aku menyembahmu, kau Allah yang hidup dan menikmati semua kemurahanmu. So let us sing Blessing Jerusalem.
Before you say that, can I have a request?
Oh yeah.
Rosha and Malcolm, can you seek the Lord and write a song for Dove Ministry?
Okay, we will do that.
Okay. All right. I think we need one of that for our Dove Ministry. Okay.
Yeah, please so pray.
Project to both of you. All right. Mm-hmm. Yes, Papa. What do you think? Huh?
Good idea.
Huh? For them?
I agree.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Spiritual Father.
Yes, thank you. Okay, let us sing for our Blessing Jerusalem. You want to share the screen, Pastor Mel?
Okay, I'm getting it now. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Let me find it now.
Was there we speak peace upon Jerusalem, we speak peace upon Jerusalem, we speak upon Jerusalem, we speak.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because you are so good. You are our great God, Father, and you never leave us. You never forsaken us, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay, so anything else?
Okay, just a quick announcement. I seek prayer, not for myself, but for the shipment that's headed towards Nepal. Pray that the ivermectin will not be confiscated or you know, that nothing will happen, that you just go through and reach the church that we're sending it to. So I covet your prayers. Thank you very much.
Okay. Pastor Tengan, can you pray for that? Mm.
Pastor Tongam, we can't hear you. We can't hear you. Sorry, we can't hear you.
No sound. Maybe you can increase your volume. Maybe this has been silent, maybe there. No, still can't hear you.
It's all right. It's all right.
It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
Tongkam, cannot hear you.
Can you hear me?
Bagus.
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 Okay. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day. This is the day that you made for us, Father.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you that we can come together to worship, to exalt your holy name, O God.
Amen.
Father, we just want to bring our brothers and sisters, our dear pastors in Nepal. Father, we thank you. Bless them, Father, this time. Lord, sometimes we don't understand what the things happen, but we know that you will take us go through, Father.
Amen.
You will meet us, Father, in this difficult heart, especially for them, Father. Lord, give them strength, give them wisdom, give them, Father, your power to overcome the situation right now in Nepal. Father, we thank you that you will continue, Father, to bless the ministry there. Even in this difficult time, Father, we can hear that you bring many souls to your kingdom, Father. So, Father, we thank you that you use them, Father, mightily to bring the love of God to the nations, to the people of Nepal, in the name of Jesus. So, Father, we thank you. We bring, Father, that you will provide also all their needs in Jesus' name. So, Father, we thank you that you use them, Father, also the churches, the believers, the pastors, as instruments to bring this love, the good news to the people. So, Father, we thank you. We glorify your holy name. Even right now, as we pray, Father, for the sick, Lord, we thank you that we pray the healing power will take place upon them, Father.
So, amen.
Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, segala perkara dapat kutanggung di dalam Dia yang memberikan kekuatan kepadaku. Itulah firman Tuhan bagi mereka, Tuhan, untuk teman-teman kami yang ada di Nepal dan juga Tuhan di beberapa daerah yang ada di India, Tuhan. Khususnya Tuhan untuk situasi COVID saat ini. Bapa, Engkaulah Tuhan yang akan terus memelihara kehidupan mereka. Dan kami memperkatakan kelimpahan mengalir atas keluarga-keluarga anak Tuhan. Kesembuhan mengalir atas keluarga-keluarga anak Tuhan. Khususnya Tuhan untuk hamba-hambamu yang melayani di sana. Pakai mereka luar biasa. Engkau pakai Tuhan segala sesuatu yang mereka miliki untuk membawa kasih-Mu kepada orang-orang yang belum mengenal Tuhan. Kami berdoa ya Bapa, di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus. Terima kasih. Haleluya. Amen.
Then sings my soul.
My shame.
Kami memuji, kami memuji.
Thank you, Father. So, I deserve Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God, for you. Thank you for your faithfulness, Father. We are so thankful to you. We are so happy because today is the day that you have made for us. And one reason. Thank you, Father. We give all glory and honor in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Over to you, Pastor Takur. For closing prayer.
Pastor Tako, can you put a closing prayer.
Closing prayer, yeah.
Hello, you can hear me?
Yeah.
Bagus, bagus.
Okay, let us pray together. Father God, we come before you. We thank you. We praise your name. We praise your holy name.
Amen.
And we thank you for your presence, oh Lord, how far we are, how is our situation, and how we are going through. You understand us in our midst. You have given your presence. You have done your work in our midst. You have given us the encouragement. You have healed us. You have done your great work in our midst, oh Lord, in this manner, in this fellowship, in this prayer, in this worship. You have given your presence. You have been with us, Lord. You have given your Holy Spirit to guide us, to lead us, and to make us near to you, closer to you. Make us more committed toward you. Make us, Lord, you have done your work, your great work in our fellowship. We thank you, Lord, in this manner. Lord, you are awesome. You are great. Father, we thank you for your presence from the beginning in this fellowship. Lord, we thank you for each and every one of us that you have given us our commitment to our Father. Lord, we ask your Holy Spirit to lead us and guide us as we depart and we dismiss from this fellowship. Lord, you bless us and you provide all our needs, each one of us, that you bless us with your protection and that we see all the risk and harm and danger in the world, in the influence of the world. But you are always there to lead us and guide us and protect us. We ask your blessings in whatever we do, whatever we plan, whatever we speak, and whatever we plan and we try to do, and whatever we involve and we engage. Lord, you bless each and every one of us. We ask your Holy Spirit, we ask your protection, we ask your guidance in our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Takur.
Welcome. God bless us all.
Thank you so much, everyone. So Charlie, you want to say something?
Okay. Don't forget tomorrow Monday, prayer meeting. Okay. 8 o'clock for Malaysian time. Canadian time is 8 a.m. Right? Yeah. So for the candidates, I'm gonna keep you up to this night, tonight, Saturday night. I know it's Saturday night, almost 11 o'clock. So it's okay, so it's, I think Nepal is morning. Right after the breakfast, join us. think talk time also morning. So thank you, everybody. So we see you again. Terima kasih, Pastor Edward.
Yeah, ambil gambar lah, Pastor Mel. Pastor Mel, take photo.
Ah, okay, okay. Nanti ya.
Pastor Tongan, sit down, take photo.
Dia biar tak.
Okay, I'm going to count to three and then you all just smile, okay? One, two, three. Okay. I take one more. Control, shift, and four. Sorry, yeah. Okay. One, two, three. Okay, got it. I'm going to put it into the group chat and then you'll see it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thanks, everyone. Thank you.
God bless. Selamat siang. Selamat pagi. Selamat tengah hari.
Selamat jalan.
Selamat jalan. Selamat malam. Good night, Canada. I love you.
Good night, Canada. We love you. Yeah.
God bless.
God bless. Shalom.
Good morning.
God bless you.
Berkati.
Good night, Papa. Mama. Good night.
Sudah tandas kurang. Sudah siap.
Thank you. See you guys.
See you all tomorrow. I'm going to do it now. Arrange the meeting. Oh, keluar?
Tunggu.
Okay.
Ayah, sudah keluar kah?
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye-bye.